Cuando quieras,
Okay.
Carlos.
Thank you. I would like to thank the organizer for giving me the opportunity to give a talk. In this lecture, I will present the work iteration operator in average radial interoperability space of analytic function done with my PhD advisor, Manuel Contreras and Luis Rodríguez Piazza. Such work appears in Mediterranean Journal of Mathematics. In this talk, we will introduce the Banach spaces. We will play a role hereinafter. Moreover, we will present the family of spaces or family spaces of analytic function with average radial integrability, the RMPQ spaces. And finally, we will show some tools such as the Littlewood-Palin inequality that will be important in the study of the integration operator. In 1923, Ries introduced the classical Hardy spaces. For Q between 0 and infinity, the Hardy spaces are formed by the holomorphic function such that the limit of the LQ norm of the integration over each circle with center 0 is finite for the case when Q is finite. And for when Q is infinity, the H infinity norm is defined by taking the supremum over the unit disk. And moreover, if Q is finite and still bigger than one, we have that the Hardy space is a separable Banach space. Indeed, the polynomial are dense in the Hardy space. And for the case when Q is infinity, we have that the closure of the polynomial is the disalgebra. And this is the set of holomorphic function that extend to a continuous function on the closed unit disk. Later on, around the 1950, Stefan Behmann present a work where the Behmann space appeared. Such work focus on the space analytic function that are square integrable over a given domain with respect to the best error measure. For P finite, the Behmann space is formed by the holomorphic function such that the LQ norm, the LP norm over the unit disk with respect to the normalized area measure is finite. And as in the same lines of the Hardy space, for P finite, the polynomials are dense in the Bellman space. And in particular, the Bellman space is a separable Banach space. And now we continue with the block space. This is a space formed by the analytic function such that the supremum of the this expression, which involves the derivative, is finite. And moreover, the block space is not separable. In this case, if we take the closure of the polynomial in the block space, we obtain the little block space. This is a closure space of the block space formed by the function such that the limit goes to zero. We follow with the space of bounded radial variation. This is a topic that goes back to Anthony Zimon and where many different authors, such as Bourguignon and Rudin, has worked. This space of analytic function consists of the analytic function such that the supremum of the integral of the derivative over its radius is finite. Bearing in mind these spaces, it's natural to consider the following spaces of analytic function with average radial integrability. And now we present the our family of spaces. For P and Q between 0 and infinity, we define the space of an analytic function RMPQ as a space where the this functional rho PQ is finite. And for P and Q finite, the functional is defined in the following way. First, we take the LP norm over the radius, and then we take the LQ norm over the torus. If P or Q are infinity, we have to change the integral by the essential supremum. And in the last case, when P and Q are infinity, this space coincides, this norm coincides with the H infinity norm. Notice that the analyticity is not required for in this definition. And we can change the essential supremum by the supremum in the case of analytic function. And in particular, we are interested in the case when P and Q are bigger than one, that is, when RMPQ is a finite space. In the same line, as in the previous slide, the RMPQ space is a Banach space, is a separable Banach space, is only if Q is finite. In fact, polynomials are dense in RMPQ. And if Q is infinity, we take the closure of the polynomial in RMPQ and RMP infinity, and we obtain the RMP zero. And this space is formed by the analytic function such that the limit of this supremum goes to zero. It will be useful to represent each space RMPQ as the point 1 over p 1 over q in the first quadrant. So for certain parameters pq of this space are well known space, for example the Bellman space. If p and q are equal, we obtain in the diagonal the Bellman space. It is just an integration. And when p is infinity in the red line, we obtain that Rn infinity q is the Hardy space Aq. This is obtained by means of the boundedness of the non-tangential maximum function. And in this point, this is the Rn 1 infinity space, it is homomorphic to the space analytic function of bounded radial variation. Notice that the function of VRV satisfies that the derivative belongs to the RM of 1 infinity. Once we have defined our spaces, we have studied the inclusion between of them. If P0 is finite, the Rn P0 Q0 space that corresponds of this point is contained in all the spaces of this green region and all the spaces in the black line without this point. And for the case when P0 is infinity, we have that this space that corresponds with the Hardy space is contained in all this space of the green region and all the space of the black line. In this case, we have the inclusion in this with this space by the Fehér-Ritz theorem. Now we continue with the Berman projection. This integral operator send the function f to a new function where k is the reproducing kernel for the Berman space A2. Moreover, we have some node properties. The Berman projection is a well-defined on L1, and it maps the function of L1 to an analytic function. And moreover, we have that the restriction of the Berman projection to the Berman space A1 coincide with the identity. And if P is finite and is bigger than one, the Berman projection is a bounded operator from LP onto the Berman space AP. And as a consequence of these properties, we obtain a description of the dual of the Berman space. For P finite at T bigger than one, the dual space of AP can be identified with the Berman space AP prime. Now, along the same line as before, we have proved that the Berman projection for P and Q finite at T bigger than one is bounded from the space LQ of LP onto the RMPQ. In order to prove this result, it's enough to show that this Berman projection is bounded from LQ of LP into itself. Since the restriction is the restriction of P to RMPQ is the identity because RMPQ is contained in A1 and PF is an analytic function of LQ LP because LQ LP is contained in L1. To obtain the result, we have used tools and techniques that come from the harmonic analysis. In particular, we use this null result due to Fefferman and Stein. And this result says the following. Let P and Q finite and strictly bigger than one. If we take the sequence measurable function, and we consider the Hardy-Littlewood maximum function of this sequence. And now with the LP norm of both sequence, and then the LQ norm, the theorem said that there is a constant such that this quantity controls this other quantity. This is the theorem gives us the boundedness of the vector maximal function. And as a consequence of the boundedness of the Berman projection, we obtain the description of the dual of the RMPQ spaces for the case when P and Q finite and strictly bigger than one. We obtain that the dual of the RMPQ is isomorphic to the RMP prime Q prime space. And we have the same identification of the Berman spaces. And now for the remaining cases, when P or Q are infinity or P or Q and one, we have that the projection don't send the LQ of LP into the RMPQ. Now we present the Littlewood-Palitan inequalities that play an important role to study the integration operator. These inequalities allow us to control the norm of the function by means of the derivative. Notice that this function is non-analytic. And this holds for P defined. Now, let's see that the Littlewood Pauli inequality don't hold for the Hardy space. That is when P is infinity. So we assume that the inequality holds for any function of the Hardy space. And now we take the lacunary series. And we will have that if F belongs to the Bloch space, then it has to belong to the Hardy spaces to AQ. But this is impossible because these lacunary series belong to the Bloch space, but not to the Hardy space. And now it's natural to ask about the converse of these inequalities. So we prove that this inequality holds for all these spaces in the green region and all these spaces in the black line. In particular, when P is equal to 1, the result has been obtained as part of a work carried out in collaboration with Petro Kananopoulos. And when Q is infinity, we point out that we don't know if the converse holds in these cases. Now we start with the last part of the talk. Now we present the operator that we are working on. Let G an holomorphic function. The integration operator TG is defined in the following way. First, we multiply the function f by the derivative of G, and then we integrate this. We study the properties and these operators and its relationship with the function G. Now we start with some known results. For the Hardy spaces with P finite, we know that the integration operator between the Hardy spaces is bounded is only if G is an analytic function of bounded mean oscillation. This result was proven by Pomerenke for P equal 2 and by Aleman and Sitkakis for the remaining cases. And what about the compactness? Aleman and Sitkakis proved that this operator is compact is only if G is an analytic function of vanishing mean oscillation. And what about when P is infinity? Now it is an open problem. In 2014, Anderson, Jovic, and Smith conjectured that this operator is bounded is only if G is an analytic function on bounded radial variation. But later on, Smith, Stoliarov, and Wolberg showed a counterexample of this conjecture and proved that the conjecture is only true when the function G is an univalent function. We continue with the case when the operator is weakly compact. We know that for P for the hardest pay when P is finer, a distinctly bigger than one, the hardest pay is a reflexive basis. So we have the integration operator is really compact, is only if it is bounded. And for the cases when P is equal to 1, like Tilla-Mäkinen and prove that this operator is weakly compact is only if G is an analytic function of vanishing Venus relation. When later on, when Contreras-Peláez-Pomeráncz-Cadrátia prove that for the case when P is infinity, that this integration operator is really compact, is only it sends the H infinity into this algebra. And now we continue with the case of Bellman spaces. Alemán-Siskákis proved that the integration operator between the Bellman space for P finite is bounded if only G belongs to the Bloch space. And moreover, they proved that this is compact is only if G belongs to the little Bloch space. And what about with the weak compactness? As in the previous case, the Bellman space is a reflexive space for P estrictly bigger than one. So we have that this operator is weakly compact is only if it is bounded. And for the case when P is equal to 1, we have that this operator is weakly compact is only if it is compact because 1 is isomorphic to the Taylor sequence L1 and it has the Schur property. The integration operator has been studied between other spaces, between the Bellman space with classical weights, between different hardness space, between the Bellman space with rapid decreasing weight, between the Bellman space and the hardness spaces, and for the case of the multivariable case, between the Dirichlet space and between the space analytic function with bounded mean oscillation by many authors like Alemán, Siskákis, Pau, Peláez, Wu, and many others. Now we start with the boundedness of the operator. As we know in the previous slide, the integration operator, we know the characterization of the integration operator in the line in red. We know that for the hardest spaces is the G have to belong to the BMA space and in the diagonal without this point, G have to belong to the Bloch space. And for the remaining cases, we prove that the integration operator is bounded is only if G is a G belongs to the Bloch space. And we have to say that the main ingredient in the proof is overstudy of the Littlewood-Palitta inequalities because if allow us to estimate the norm of this product instead of estimate the norm of the TG of F. And we follow with the compactness. As we know, the characterization of the integration operator between the hardest spaces, G have to belong in this case for the BMA space and for the be my space, ye have to belong in the little blue space. And now we prove that in the remaining cases, the integration operator between the R and PQ space is compact, is only if G belongs to the little blue space. And now we continue with the study of the weak compactness. As we know, the integration operator between the two binary space is weakly compact if the image of the unit ball of the X is a relatively weakly compact subset of Y. In this case, we're interested in the study of the cases when X and Y are non-reflexive space, because if X and Y is reflexive, then every bounded operator is weakly compact. And since R and PQ is reflexive when P and Q are finite, it is bigger than one, and we know that for the Hardy spaces, when Q is finite, HTTP bigger than 1, we know the Hardy spaces are reflexive. So we are dealing with, in this session, it's only interesting that in these three cases, in the orange line, in the blue line, and the red line, because these three points are known cases. The H1 cases, the RM 1-1, and the H infinity case. So we continue with the study of these three cases. When Q is infinity, this red line, we know that these cases is given by the this theorem of Contreras-Pelham-Pomerenkian-Ratia, where the integration operator is weakly compact is only if it sends the H infinity into the disalgebra. And remember that the disalgebra is the closure of the polynomial in the infinity, and the RMP0 is the closure of the polynomials in LP infinity. And following the previous result, we have the along in the same line the previous result, we have the for the case when P is finite and HTTP bigger than 1 is weakly compact is only if the integration operator between the R and P0 is weakly compact, and it is equivalent to the fact that the operator send the bigger one into the little one. An important tool used in the proof of the result is the identification of the bidual of the RMP0 with the RMP infinity space. In this case, we don't know about the characterization of the weak compactness of the operator in terms of the holomorphic function G. It's still open. And now, what happened in the case when P are equal to 1? Before to start, we need to give the following definition. The operator let X, Y, and E in binary space. This operator fix a copy of E if there exists a subspace A of X such that A and E are isomorphic and this operator restricted to A and TA is an isomorphic. And now if we take the function G, this logarithm that belongs in the block space but not in the little block space, we have that this operator is bounded and fills a copy of L1. And in particular, this is not weakly compact. So we don't have the previous characterization for the spaces for the page of in this red line. And moreover, if we consider the same function and P final at TP1, this operator is weakly compact, as we know, and it is not a compact for the spaces in the red line. And now, when in the following case, when Q is equal to 1, this is the orange line. The case when P is equal to 1, sorry, the case when P is equal to infinity, Mäkinen prove that this operator in this case is weakly compact is only if it is compact and is only if G belongs to the pair of analytic function with vanishing mean oscillation. And the other point, we know that this operator here is weakly compact is only if it is compact because A1 is isomorphic to the spatial sequence L1. And now for the remaining cases, we prove that the integration operator between the RMP1 is weakly compact is only if compact and is only if G belongs to the little block space. And moreover, we obtain a characterization in terms of fills a copy of a certain panel space. We have that the operator is weakly compact is only if TG does not fix a copy of L1, and it is equivalent to the fact that the adjoint of TG does not fill a copy of C0. And now we follow with the more interesting case for me because we obtain a more curious result, and we develop different techniques to obtain this result. First, we give a functional characterization of the boundedness of the weak compactness of the integration operator in the space between the space of the blue line. When Q is final at TP1, we prove that the integration operator between RM1Q is weakly compact is only if the integration operator from RM1Q into the Riemann space A1 is compact. And it is equivalent to the fact that this integration operator does not fill a copy of L1. And now we ask about if there is a characterization in terms of G. So after before that we have to define the following space. The weekly little block space is a subspace of the block space where this limit that involves the derivative goes to zero for almost every point in the torus. And the weakly little block space is a closed subspace of the block space, and it is contained between is strictly contained between the little block space and the block space. Moreover, as we know, if G is an additive function whose imaginary part has a finite angular limit at this point, we have that this function has an angular limit zero at the same point. In fact, if we take an additive function that belongs to the block space and whose imaginary part has infinite finite angular limit at almost every point in the torus, then G have to belong to the weakly little block space. And in particular, the function that belong in the hard space P and in the block space are contained in the weakly little block space. And now we give a characterization in terms of characterization of the weak companions operator at that function G. We prove that for Q finite t bigger than 1, that the integration operator between Rn 1 Q is weakly compact is only G belongs to the weakly little block space. And this result relies on the characterization of the weak compactness of a certain operator into the L1 and on the classical result about vector maximal function that we saw in the previous slides. This is all.
Okay. Thank you, Tanasu, for your talk. And now is the right time for questions or comments. Do we have any questions?
Yes, Tanasu, may I ask you one thing?
Okay.
So, I guess you mentioned that the little block space is the closure of the polynomials, right? In the block norm.
Yeah.
So, is it the case that this weak little block space is it also the closure of some other space of functions?
I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing.
Yeah, it. But the question makes sense, right? It could happen that it's the closure of a bigger set of functions which contains polynomials, right?
Could you repeat the question?
Sí, no, quiero decir que es probable que así como el espacio de sub cero
sí.
Es la clausura de los polinomios en la norma block,
sí.
Tiene a lo mejor este weak little block space es la clausura de un conjunto de funciones mayores, ¿no? que el conjunto de
sí.
Polinomios, ¿no?
Yeah, but I don't know. I don't know if
Okay.
there is this
Anyway,
about the separability, no.
well, thanks. Thanks for the nice talk, anyway.
Thank you, Artur, for your question. Fernando, what about your questions?
Yes. Hello, Eransu. Nice talk.
Hello.
Congratulations for your talks. I have one first of all, a stupid question. Why the name RMPQ? Rodríguez, this is Rodríguez Piazza and Manolo Contreras, for example. I don't know what is the reason.
Is the radial mean space is a name.
Well, and now, well, in the first transparencies in the definition of your spaces RMPQ, my question is, what about the space of function such that the derivative belong to this spaces RMPQ? I think it's the counterpart for join your this spaces with the Dirichlet space, or the spaces involving the derivative, I think. Do you mean I understand? Do you understand me? Or so, how you study something about these spaces, or is interesting, or
You say about with the derivative.
see. The class, I mean the spaces, is the space. The space is the analytic function such that the derivative, the first derivative, belong to RMPQ.
When I started the thesis, I studied the RMPQ spaces and the a variant of this space with the derivatives, but we focus on in the spaces or RMPQ.
Okay.
But I know about the question of Daniel Girela, I know. The weakly little block space is a non-separable space.
Okay.
I remember that. I forgot.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.
Daniel
Artur Nicolau.
Girela.
Okay, any further questions or comments? Okay, then I have a question for you, Tanausu. At the very beginning of your talk, you have present the Bergman projection, right? But it's the Bergman projection induced by the weight equals one, the constant weight, okay? You may consider, for example, some other Bergman projections induced by standard weights, right? Have you thought about the boundedness of these projections on your Bergman spaces, on your spaces?
I studied the some result where, for example, with the Toeplitz operator, is a more general case of the Bergman projection. But we are working on this. But
Okay.
in the we but we have that the Bergman space with a certain weight is not RMPQ space. Is that
Okay.
your question?
Well, more or less, I would like to have, if you, for example, if you have a standard weight, okay, the distance to the boundary of the boundary of the disk to a power, and I would like to know when the induced projection is bounded on your space. This is my question. To classify the exponent so that the Berman projection is bounded on your spaces. This is what came to my mind.
In this case, I don't know.
Okay, seems to me that you have work to do. Okay, and now I'm going to present a question by the professor José Bonet, because he has no option to make the question directly to you, and then he's wondering about the anisomorphic classification of your spaces. AIPQ. If you have thought about anisomorphic classification.
We don't see about this. We only know, he said that we have the inclusion, but not the isomorphic classification.
Exactly.
I don't see about this, but it's a good question.
Okay. Great. Plenty of questions today. Some more questions?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Okay.
Wait. Can I ask a question or not?
Yes, of course. Let's go, Oscar.
Sorry. I really enjoyed the talk, but I would like to know whether these spaces that you call RMPQ can be really obtained by using interpolation between classical spaces. You understand what I mean? Maybe this mixed norm space that you have been considering maybe can be really realized like an interpolation space. Have you thought on that?
About this, no. You say that if we can obtain the RPQ space as an interpolation between a classical space.
Yes, this is the question.
Yes. Yes. We are trying to, we are trying in some cases, for example, for the inclusion, the interpolation between the Berman space and, but in, I think that to obtain the, okay, when we are, trying to prove the boundaries of the Berman projection, we use some result of interpolation to obtain the boundaries, but this is the only case that we study interpolation of this.
Yes, but more anyway, thank you.
Great. Some more questions? No? Okay, then let's thank the speaker again.